Hi, everybody. I'm Eric Escudero with the EERE Digital Team. We're in Denver, Colorado, near the new commuter rail line that connects the airport to downtown. In just over a year from now, this place will be packed with people and innovation as the U.S. Department of Energy's Solar Decathlon comes to the Mile High City. Dates are now set for the 2017 competition. From October 5th through the 15th, 14 college teams will design, build, and operate solar-powered houses that are cost-effective, energy-efficient, and boast maximum curb appeal. Teams are judged on 10 events, ranging from architectural design to occupancy, health, and comfort. And for the first time, cash prizes are on the line, totaling nearly $2 million. For more on the competition, we head out to Washington, D.C., where Jeremy Kahn is standing by with Linda Silverman, the new Solar Decathlon director.
Thanks, Eric. We're here in the National Mall in Washington, D.C., the site of the first four solar decathlons. And Linda, it's coming up on a year very quickly. What do you think?
Very excited. We're working really hard on all aspects of the competition. Looking forward to it.
Yeah, and what new items are coming up in the competition this year?
So this year we have two new contests as part of the 10 contests. One is innovation, which is really focused on getting the decathletes to push the envelope on clean energy technology, building technology, and incorporating financial sustainability in that. And then also water conservation and reuse.
Can't wait to see some of those changes. What do you think the impact of Solar Decathlon has been so far?
It has an amazing impact. First on workforce development of these students, but also the faculty and the universities, which really are applying theory to practice. DOE, our private sector partners, our university partners, they toil away in obscurity, and this really gives the public the ability to see really the types of clean energy transformation that we're trying to make and how we're using our investments. And then the other thing I love about this competition is it's very multidisciplinary. So, you know, of course the architects and engineers are involved, but then also we need communication students. We need web designers, we need interior decorators, we even need chefs, financial and economic analysts. All that is part of the competition. And we're hoping that people see that clean energy is really for everyone to both embrace but also to work in. So we're hoping to have a bigger and wider net for workforce development.
There's so much involved in the Solar Decathlon. You have a lot of work ahead of you, so we're going to let you get back to work, and we're going to throw it back to Denver, the site of the 2017 Solar Decathlon.
Thanks, Jeremy. You can check out a number of activities free of charge throughout the event, including public exhibits, a community festival, professional development, and consumer workshops and education days for kids. This marks the eighth U.S. competition dating back to 2002 and the first one to be held in Denver. Previous locations include Southern California and Washington, D.C. For more information, log on to the Solar Decathlon website, solardecathlon.gov.